Hi guys, welcome to the Fit Rush, and today I'm just doing a regular walk. So I'll just show you some of the places where I walk and what it looks like during the time of lockdown. Now, since that the rules are not that strict anymore, they're allowing us to walk outside. So I'll just show you what the place where I walk looks like. Today I'm going through a different route. So this is Haripad's main junction. These are all the stores or the commercial stores that are there at Haripad. I think there's a storm coming. It's going to rain. Totally empty road today. This is the electricity board, Kerala Electricity Board building. So one of the few malls that's there in Haripad, you can see over here, Ace Mall. Very common place that we all go to. There's a restaurant there called Hangout. They make very nice burgers, very nice pizzas. Overall, very nice place to go and visit and chill out. We are actually heading towards, there's a temple called Haripad Subramanya Temple, and that's at the end of that road. So because of the lockdown, the temples are all closed and nobody's allowed to go inside, but maybe I can show you what it looks like outside. It's actually a very, very big temple. I think one of the most famous temples in Haripad. All right, this is what the arch of the temple looks like. It is a huge arch, I would say at least about 100 feet tall. So the statue in the middle that you see is actually the main deity of the temple, which I was talking about. That is Lord Muruga. I think you can spot him here. So he's considered to be the god of war. Okay, so now we are at the pond of the temple. Just show you what the pond looks like. So that is actually where all the activities and program of the temple happens. The temple entrance is right there behind the tree. And as you can see, this is actually a smaller pond. This pond is teeming with fishes. You can't see them right now though, but there are a lot of fishes. Yes, so now you can see this is the main temple that I'm talking about. You can see the main entrance over there to the temple. Now people are actually not allowed to go inside, but it is a very, very beautiful temple, and it started to rain. Remember I showed you a pond of the temple, and if you thought that was big, check this out. This is a massive pond. This pond also has a lot of fishes. This pond is majorly used for people to have a bath in, because it's very, very large. There's a separate entrance for elephants also, if they want to scrub the elephants and give them a bath. This is where they bring them. Usually the norm in Kerala, every big temple has an elephant associated with it. They use the elephant for religious ceremonies. Although they're used for religious ceremonies, they are being taken care of really, really well. Let me try showing you what the pond looks like. So this is the bigger pond. This place is huge. It goes all the way there. And what you see there is actually part of the temple. Okay, so we are at one of the entrances of the temple. This is the arch. Yeah, I think you would have noticed a pattern that every temple, or rather big temple in India or Kerala, always has an arch to show you that that's the entrance. This is the entire parking area. The temple goes on for till the end. So the temple is somewhere in between that. That's where the temple is at. Right now, because of lockdown, it's totally closed and nobody's allowed to go. we are just going to go to the till the entrance, the main entrance of the temple, and we're going to turn around and be back. We are done with 2.3 kilometers of walk. What a typical government school looks like in Kerala. You can see it's like it's a single story building. All the classrooms are here. These are all the classes. They have a huge ground for them to play. But unfortunately, due to the lockdown, it's completely shut. Yeah. Actually quite nicely maintained, to be honest. Now that we have completed about 2.69 kilometers, we are slowly heading back home before it rains, and we also have like a curfew time limit where we are, like I said, we have a small curfew time limit where we are about to overcross, so we don't want to do that. We don't want to get caught. And as you all know, it's very difficult to walk with a mask, so we are heading back. So remember I was telling you a place where they bring the elephants to bathe them? This is the exact place. So you can see the slope over here. So they get the elephant over here, the elephant enters into the water, and that's how they bathe the elephants. They get a nice scrubbing down over here. The water is fairly clean, even though it looks a little green, but it's actually clean water. Yeah, I think we've come to the end of the video. Hope you guys really liked this video. If you did, please drop a like, comment, share and subscribe. And I shall see you again in another video. Stay safe, stay fit.